It's no secret that the Kia Sonet is the hipper, trendier, and a more eager-to-please version of the Hyundai Venue. In fact, even its name is an acronym for social network, SoNet, get it? With Kia dropping so many hints, it's time to drive the car and test the tech. Come on in. Inside the Kia Sonet, it's an impressive place indeed. It feels like a class or maybe even two above the competition. The touch points are all wrapped in nice soft leather. It feels nice to hold. There's a flat bottom steering wheel. I am driving the IMT here. Even that is wrapped in leather. You also get a knurled finish on the center console. The carpets as well are so funky and so different for this class of car. I really like that. Also, I think the ventilated seats could be just the next best thing after sliced bread because they have literally saved my back in more ways than one, especially on this hot and sultry day in Mumbai. Of course, the biggest talking points of the Kia Sonet are its huge 10.25-inch screen, which is all touch right here. You also get a small auxiliary screen, which is a 4.2-inch unit right in the driver's line of sight, and a segment first, which is a 7-speaker Bose audio system. So you have 2 speakers on the front doors each. You get 2 speakers at the back, which are full range, and you get a subwoofer mounted in the boot. There is no center channel right behind the touchscreen right here. But overall, I've spent about 2 hours with the car right now, and the sound is pretty impressive. The bass has weight, it has definition. The highs, like typical Bose speakers, they don't want to tear your head off. They are very well contained and tamed. Overall, it's a great experience, and even though there is no physical center speaker, they have tuned the system so well that it feels like it's imaging from the center, and that's really good. Apart from being an audiophile, I don't think there is any reason to go for an aftermarket upgrade with this audio system. So the focal point of the cabin in the Kia Sonet is of course the 10.25-inch screen, and it is capacitive. So the touch response is very fluid, it's responsive, it always works. And it's quite large, the touch points themselves, so it's very hard to miss a button, a virtual button. Apart from that, it also has a couple of segment first features, but there is one which is a world first feature, and that's an AQI filter with virus protection. Now, we've seen air filters in a lot of new cars these days, but this one has a virus protection filter, and that means it actually has a HEPA and a UVC sterilizer right inside the armrest. And it's very easy to replace as well by the user, depending on where you live. After a few months or a few weeks, you might need to replace this depending on how polluted your air quality is around the surroundings. But it's very easy to do and it really works. Right now it's showing me an AQI of 35. We are on the outskirts of Mumbai, skies are blue and it's reflecting accurate data. Besides supporting Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, there's also another unique feature in the Kia Sonet infotainment system. For the first time now, you can connect up to 2 Bluetooth devices simultaneously to the infotainment system. That means you can connect one phone only for hands-free calling and the other phone maybe for your music playback. And the advantage of that is great because if you have a co-passenger who wants to play their choice of music, they can do that without having to get into your phone. Also, the wireless charging tray itself is large enough to even accommodate the biggest phone on the market right now, which is the Samsung Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. So if it fits this, it's going to fit any other phone. Besides that, of course, it has 2 USB charging ports right at the front, one at the back. And we're going to talk about the UO system now. The UO system in the Kia Sonet is very similar to the Hyundai Venue's BlueLink system. Of course, they are a family and they have similar technologies. And the UO is said to have 57 features that you can access from your smartphone. But apart from that, it also has for the first time a voice assistant that wakes up with the command, "Hello Kia. Can you open the driver's side window?"
Opening the driver's window.
And it really works as advertised. Sadly though, the features that you can interact with are very, very limited with the voice assistant, and I've been trying a few of them. The only thing that really worked was the AC temperature control and the driver's side window, which would be convenient if you're approaching a toll booth and you don't want to use your fingers, grubby fingers, on the window button itself. So it's a feature out there. Of course, it's going to be improved over time with updates. And that's another thing about this UO system. It can actually be updated over the air. It has an embedded SIM with a 3-year subscription plan. It has built-in sat-nav, so you can have your native maps as well, even in case you forgot your phone at home. And everything is covered for 3 years. But apart from all the features on this top-end system, Kia Sonet will be available in a myriad of options and array of variants, just like on the Kia Seltos. So this is the 10.25-inch screen, which is the top-end variant. But it starts from a 3.8-inch screen, which is very, very basic. Then you move on to an 8-inch screen, which is the mid-level. And then you move on to this, which is the top-end screen. So when you're buying a Kia Sonet with all these features in mind, make sure that you choose the right variant, because this is not going to be for everyone. With so many segment first and even a world first feature, Kia has done well to lure its potential base of customers. If you are a yuppie who's looking for tech and a lifestyle vehicle, this one sits at the top of the pack.